feeling when I've had to stand here for over 5 minutes waiting for all the arrows to disappear out of my chest before I could start recording. But welcome back everybody to another episode of Minecraft Xbox. Today I find myself stood up way above all the clouds in our extreme amplified world because I decided I was going to fly up here and test my ability to shoot myself with a bow. Turns out I'm getting a little bit better. But what I really want to do is see if I can get myself onto the peaks before we get into the main bulk of the episode. So let's see what we can do with what we have. While we're flying past here, all this area will eventually get dug out. There's a cow there. And you wonder why I've got no animals in my upper sections of my world. So let's just boost ourselves back up and then go straight up. Dead easy. And then we're almost level with it now. It's quite difficult to shoot. There we go. A little bit higher. Almost world limit. Let's sky our way through this area. There's an entire section here that I really don't visit enough. So yeah, I can just shoot my way all the way up and even probably go above this.
We'll be right back.
Now, as you saw from that clip I've just played, you will have noticed we found a couple villagers, which is super cool. Now, this is the second time I'm trying to record this clip after the time-lapse, because I had some issues with my microphone again, using the standard one that it automatically chooses instead of my actual blue snowball. So, yeah, I've kind of already gone through this all once. I'm lucky I don't have autosave on, so at least I can revert backwards and try this all again, and not make the same mistakes twice. So, essentially, previously what we did is we flew all the way up to the village, with all Neverportal gears, maps, flint and steels, you name it, and essentially we decided to push the villagers into the Nether. Sadly, as I pushed the villagers into the Nether, they despawned or they suffocated before I could get there, which is really, really annoying, but what it means we're going to have to do with the villagers to save them, to get them to our town, which is just below us here, we're on the island right in the sky, is we're going to have to use, like, an extended, like, it's going to have to be water. It's going to have to be, like, an aqueduct, essentially, a flat aqueduct that I can delete afterwards when I've got the villagers over here, because there's no way I'm going to get two villagers from God knows how far that way, and from over there, all the way back here, without killing them in some way or another. It's going to be very difficult to get them here, and it's going to take us a couple of episodes to plan it out. The other alternative is for me to extend out the track down there through a tunnel onto a bridge, and then bring it out far enough that I can drop water from the mountain onto the track. That might be the easier options, considering the track has to be built anyway. So what we'll do is we'll kind of have a look up there and we'll see how far of a distance it is. It's about 200 blocks. So it's going to be a lot of work. So, is that a creeper down there? Oh, it's just grass. Okay, so what we're going to do, let's fly over there. Let's see what if I can actually do something. Nope. Let's just lose all our speed smashing into a mountain. That cow can die. That's the issue I have in my world also, is the fact that I have so many mobs spawning on all these tall hills that essentially I've got nothing to do. So yeah, here's where I was looking for, is the bridge would actually extend through here. Can I get through this without crashing? Nope. I am going to slowly make my demise here. Fly all the way down. Okay, let's just fly back up a bit. Let's get ourselves a bit of pace. But yeah, as you saw, you could kind of see where the track is planned to go. It's very tricky getting used to flying, especially because I'm still not great at it, and I've got to kind of learn how to do it. So it's hit. I've got to shoot twice for it to work, is the issue. But it's so slow. So we were actually started higher up than we actually are now. This tells you how difficult it is to actually fly. Can I hit myself again? There we go. I can get up a bit. Don't hit the top of that mountain. We're going to circle back round, and hopefully we should be high enough when we circle round to get ourselves back up there. So yeah, we're looking to be up there. There's just... What I'm noticing is the bow doesn't do as much as I thought it did on the PC. You actually do have to shoot yourself quite a bit to go up. To go straight, it's not too bad. You just kind of just stay straight. And you just do this consistently. But to go up, it's rather tricky. Because you kind of have to shoot yourself, aim up, but then not too high because you might knock yourself off. We're getting there. We're getting back up into the peaks again. I'm going straight at that mountain if I don't shoot myself twice. And I failed to do it. Alright, it's just not consistent enough. Like, I can do that. But then, nothing from anywhere onwards. Just give me a sec, everybody, while I get up there, because I've spent way too long already in the sky. Oh, we actually landed it. Well, that was a little bit surprising. I didn't expect to shoot myself straight up into the sky. I saw a couple sheep down there. Can I still be able to, can I find them? There's one there. Oh no, is that my arrow? Yeah, there was two sheep on the edge of that cliff. But yeah, I've managed to land myself just short of where they are. Hi, skeleton. Oh, something else is shooting me. The skeleton. It's half leather. Probably some really awful piece of armor. Not too shabby. I'm actually low on health. So I need to be careful. That's a well. So how have I actually been getting up? Previously, I was building up here before I stopped saving because obviously everything was a bit messed up. Let's use wood. I know it's not the most inconspicuous of blocks, and what I probably should have also done is thought about it being day before I started doing this. So what I'll actually do is I'll dig out a little bit of a staircase this time. It might be a bit easier. See, it takes us out here anyway. So what we do have up here is a library, two li what should have two librarians. There should be one in this house, which he is. He's still in there. Oh, that's a creeper. Let's just take him down. We should have a farmer in the house at the top. Should also be another librarian in the top, but I think he's despawned. Last time I was over here, he wasn't in the building, so. So yeah, let's just pillar up. Is he still there? I don't think so. I think he's gone. Oh no, he's still here too. Okay. So yeah. So what our plan is, we're going to have to do with these villagers is we're going to have to take them up. Can I not land like a single jump today? This is getting on my nerves a little bit. So yeah, we should have our farmer in there as well. What I probably should have done is come up here with some name tags. Because yeah, we've got all the three villagers are nice and safe up here. What we're going to have to do is take them along the zero track line, which is actually, if we look down, we should be able to see where it comes through. It should be basically just down there. So we're going to actually have to, it should be like dead center through that section there, which is nice. What we also have is the bit that I was pointing to you guys at. Let's get a little bit further down the hill. Let's just settle ourselves on this island here by this tree. There we go. You should be able to see the other bit that I'm talking about. Basically there. You see that little line there, right where my cursor is, that straight line. So that's going to be the tunnel. So what I'm thinking off camera is I'm going to extend the tunnel beyond out this way and do the sec and do a full length. Obviously, it's going to be much easier when it's just the wooden section of the bridging, because obviously that center section is actually supposed to be different to make it stand out. So yeah, when we get to about there, it should become dead easy. It should be just that wooden structures that I was going with. Don't really need to do any struts and supports under it yet. The bridge can be done a different day. But essentially, when that's done, what I'll do is I'll get some minecarts and boats. Might be easy with a boat. And drop a water source from up there, roll it down, and basically straight down onto the track. That's a full chain skeleton down there. Let's just make them die. Am I one-shotting them? That guy I'm definitely not going to one-shot. I wonder if he dropped anything. Let's just have a fly down. I doubt it. Yeah, just a couple bits of zombie flesh from the zombies. Nothing to worry about. Oh, he dropped his bow, which is just plain. Oh well. So let's head back. I've got other things I can be doing while I'm waiting for it. And also, should be killing all the animals around here. So let's kind of take a stop here. Let's play a bit of a shooting game quickly. And let's just clear out any animals that are on the sides of my mountains. Because it's essentially, it's stopping me breeding all my animals in the center, which is really annoying. I knew I'd seen another one. Right, so that's three animals down. And if I move quick enough, they should not spawn in the area. Okay, sorry pig, but you can't be up here because you're basically just preventing all my spawns. I could have sworn I saw something further up as well. So let's just do a quick pillar up. Let's just do a bit of a jump and hop. It actually puts us easier to fly back from when we're up here. We can do a bit of a skydive down. So, looking around, I'm not seeing too many animals up on here. I thought I saw one, but I guess not. It might have been just me seeing the light grey flowers, the azuli and something else. Yeah, I don't think there was any more up here. But yeah, from here, you get a really cool view of the town itself. Now, you can tell that there's all these really random little islands sticking up. Like, that's an island, which I obviously thought was part of the land. That's quite a big chunky one. I haven't actually been over to this one. Let's just take a fly over here. There's a spider there. So let's just jump up. Hello, Mr. Spider. You can die. So what I do need to do with these islands is light them up. Because, yes, they're up in the sky. They do help reduce the mob spawn rates down below. But it's also kind of one of those things that maybe I should, might even have to slab them. But slabbing them seems to be a bit of an overkill, if you know what I mean. But yeah. So essentially, I'm going to have to extend this track out to get them villagers down. So for now, we need to stay out of render distance of that. Or at least go back up there and light them up to keep them safe at a different point. But for now, what I want to do is go and show you guys the progress I've made on the dam. Now, obviously, last episode, I was showing you what we were needing to do. Let's just swoop round here. Let's just dive down. There we go. But yeah, so what we were needing to do is I was trying to show you how to center it. But obviously, as you can tell, I've made a huge amount of progress. What's keeping me back now is andesite and my lack of it. Because these middle structures here and here are a random selection amount of stone brick and andesite. The stone is running down the centers, and I think I've got it just in the right places because I've had to dig out a little bit there. But most of that mountain won't be there anyway. Most of that is going to disappear and it's going to flatten off. That's going to be remaining the same. There's a cow down there. But yeah, I want to kind of raise it up a bit more and get the quartz structuring in on it, because I think that'd look nice. And then we can take our beacons to it. When the beacons get fixed, we can clear out some of this land and link up the water. Because this should show us into the second part of the town, which I want to do at some point, because it's got some nice flowing waters around here. And I've got some ideas of how to link it to an area through where we originally said we wanted to put some mini-games. Now, obviously, it's all about me building them for now, but the mini-games world's a little bit further out into the flat section, which is round here, as you can tell. So, all the animals here haven't been despawning, which is an interesting issue. But yeah, I've been keeping this area safe for a future project. I want to kind of build not a Hunger Games map, but more like the attack and defend map back from Season 2. I had the idea for it for back then, where it was a castle which you attacked, and it makes perfect sense to use this backdrop, which basically levels off against the edge of the world on this side of the map, where it goes back to the normal terrain, essentially. It gives the perfect opportunity to have a castle extend backwards, and then we can hide it in the sides of an amplified hill. Let's try and get... Oh, I just realized what bow I was using. Oh, that's my stupidity there. Oh. That was very strange. I just seem to have launched myself out of my world. But yeah, most of this is unexplored terrain, as you can tell, with the big, huge structure on the side of the mountain. Let's just try and shoot ourselves. Let's get a bit further. Or not. Might be a bit easier case. Let's just keep flying. Let's not eat that. So there's a wandering water source there we do need to deal with at some point. But yeah, we also need to get some sponges, which is another big thing I need to do at some point, is to find a guardian temple. I know I found one when I was exploring way back when, but I don't remember where it is, so it might be worth going back out at some point with a better set of gear and exploring again. And you've got all these really cool potential places around the map. Now that we have our wings, I can show you some of the things that were put into the world. For example, this tower. Now, you may remember this tower from way back when. I almost killed myself. That was good on me. But yeah, this tower comes out of the test world. Well, it's originally out of the single player on the Xbox 360 edition. So if you want to know how to build this, you essentially should just go back to watch episodes 14 and 15 or 13 and 14 of that series. And that's how to do it. There's also a tutorial on how to build this on my channel, in fact. It's dead simple. And notice how the middle bit got changed for these single things, because now you can actually still not get it because of the hitbox being weird, but you can look down it much easier now. But yeah, so this is kind of the edge of the world, and I've been exploring this quite a lot recently, just to kind of see what potential I've got on the outskirts of the amplified section. My main focus, obviously, is going to be developing the amplified. Can I shoot myself back up? Thank you. And let's just eat while I'm in boost mode. There's a couple things like this that you see that shouldn't have updated but have. There's a couple bits of sugarcane on this side as well. And then also, you've got the potential of the second town, which I think is in this area. Yes, it's over here. Let's just fly our way up. So we've actually just shot ourselves basically round the map on our elytra to where, again, the test world town was originally going to be. I had so many ideas for this thing, basically to use this ravine section here. Oh, that was a... I just decided to start moving very quickly and under the bridge. But yeah, that's kind of that. I'm actually getting better at shooting myself. So yeah, this is the track style that I was going on about that we're going to use, is this thing. Can I get through the tunnel? Oh, look at that. Through the tunnel. That was beautiful. Let's just fly our way back up and land back down with the horses. There we go. But yeah, so that's kind of what I'm trying to thinking of doing in the future. So what I'm probably going to have to do off camera, or maybe in a time lapse at the beginning of next episode, is build the rest of the track extension fully off of that in that direction. We're also going to then have to get all the wood supplies ready to continue it beyond, so I can get the villagers down in a boat and then get them essentially to ride the boat down, and then I will put them in a minecart afterwards and then shove them back to center, because eventually I want to have a villager breeder and keep the villagers nice and safe, because I've got an idea for having a nice village town on islands in the sky, which I was going to make, Or we kind of use the islands that are pre-existing over here and link them together, but they're quite big, and I'd rather have a nice little secluded section just above the town here, and this nice big open space for a nice villager, essentially slash villager breeder, iron farm slash village, because it'd be really cool to give it access to the point of using my bow again. Because eventually, I do want to get the pirate ship in as well, which I'm thinking the pirate ship really needs to be above the water somewhere around here, especially with the dam, which is going to be up there. Because I have plans for the upper section of this now as well. I don't have Depth Strider boots, so what I do need to do is get out the water. I've also got a lot of arrows in my face now as well. Come on, keep going. So slow. But yeah, so let's kind of. I noticed I've kind of just flown over a lot of stuff very quickly there, and I apologize for doing things like that. It's just, I have habits of just ranting on, and then plus the elytra doesn't slow down very well. I'm not very consistent with it yet. I'm still getting used to it, is my issue. But yeah, we've got all this water we did in the last episode, which has turned out pretty good. I've also f then finished off this section here and got the texturing done. It's very stony at the moment. It does need a bit of color, so we may need to add a couple trees in here and there. May drop that down there, get a tree in, and so on. But yeah, I'm thinking a dam. The important thing about a dam is they need a source of water to hold back. Now, this dam's water source is going to have to be about this height because of the fact that it sticks up way above it. It's going to have the path there, and then it's going to have essentially a water source at that height, which means a lot of this is going to disappear. But also, I'm thinking it should have a higher up section that flows down into a lower lake, because essentially this wall should disappear, I think. I don't think this wall needs to be here anymore. Yes, it kind of cuts out the town and circles it off, but planning this thing's been quite tough as it is. You can see all the mess that I've been making as I've been doing it. But that's going to be a wall. It's going to be a lot higher. It's going to have a little one gap underneath it. The inspiration for this is quite. I essentially just looking at waterfall dams, and I'm getting there slowly with it. I've got the pattern with it down this bit now. It's just I kind of need to figure out what I'm doing here. I may look up a tutorial to see if anybody's got anything similar to this. I don't think this nine gap might be a bit awkward to fit some sort of funky mechanism that would have normally lifted your gates up to flood the water through. Because at the moment, it's going to have like a one or two gap at the base where the water will have dropped down through the back of the dam on the inside and will flow out, because the water height's actually going to be a lot higher. It's going to be about this height here. And it's going to be held back by obviously the top of the layers. It's going to be about a five gap to the top, and there'll be the walkway there, which is nice. It does mean we're going to need a new walkway on this section as well. It's going to continue across, and that should give us like a cross section for the town. What I'll do is I'll cut out everything up to it, so everything about here will disappear, because it should flow a lot better if it flows towards a dam, which is cutting off this, I'd say, posh section of the town. Would essentially it'd be a lot better. But yeah, it's a lot of things that I need to do, grindy stuff off camera. You guys won't be really interested in watching me dig out a massive area when the beacons have been fixed and flowing the water. I'm gonna get this thing done as soon as I can, because I've got some more interesting things I'd like to do on camera when it's finished. But yeah, the other issue I've been noticing recently, let's fly over here, is the sheep. I need to just twirl my way around. Now, originally, we had a lot of sheep in this pen, and essentially, the sheep keep dying and suffocating in the fence posts. So this is why I've actually just broke my helmet. Oh, well done. Didn't even notice that happen. But yeah, essentially, I've had to put wool all the way around it to stop the sheep suffocating. I'm not sure if they're actually suffocating or they're despawning because they're not in the area. But then again, I was moving the horses recently, and you'll notice I've had to put them in a pen as well. And I've dug them into the ground first because essentially every time I was flying out of the area, the leads attached to the horses were despawning. So they were dropping off the horses before I could get them. And then essentially what was happening is the horses were just roaming free. So I dug them into a hole, and sadly, two of them suffocated for no reason, the diamond guy and the other one. But luckily, I managed to rescue their stuff. I kind of saw it on the floor just in time. So now we have these three in here, and I'm hoping they'll be fine. There's a wild dog over here. I'm wondering if this is taking up spawning potential, because I have not many animals around here, and I'm having to do the old tactic of I could have I got, there's babies in here as well. I'm pretty sure there was. There was little cows. See, this is the other issue. Is, have they despawned? Because I was breeding cows earlier. There should have been at least 6 in here. There's only 5. See, this is the other issue is... Everything you do gets undone by the fact that the game's got a limiting factor of mobs. It just doesn't let you spawn enough of them. Like, I've got 3 horses... Okay, for a set there was only 2 in that pen. 3 horses there. Got 5 cows in there. Got the odd wolf standing around here and there, but they're not even on the same thing. Then you've got this pen of about 15 chickens, which I keep walking past accidentally picking heads up. There's 3... Stay still, chickens, so I can count you, please. So the near wall, we've got 4, 6, 7, 10, 11. So there's 11 in there, and then we've got 8 sheep. So yeah, we've got dogs around like this. But that's still only like 30 mobs. We should be able to spawn a hell of a lot more than that. In fact, that's 19 plus the 5 plus... Yeah, that's 26 or 27. So if I've got mobs around, especially wolves, the wolves will probably round up to about 30. So it's telling me... Especially if this game's got a limit of about 50 mobs in an area, like in the loaded chunks. It's telling me there are 20 mobs that keep spawning up at the tops. But there's one way to get around it, and that's to log out of the game and spawn them, and essentially breed your animals beforehand. But yeah, it's been getting on my nerves with you. It's one of the things that really bugs me about this game. Oh, and there's this one pig in this boat as well. Which he isn't even in the boat, is he? Is he in the boat? Can I get in the boat with you? So you are in the boat. So I can ride this pig around all I want. So this is what I'm hoping to do with the villagers is a prime example. And then just flow them down the water. Let's just get out of that. But yeah, it's been a little bit of a catch up. We need to figure out some stuff with the villagers. So essentially, we'll have a couple back-to-back episodes here. I'll do a bit of grindy work off camera. And I will see you guys again in the next one. I hope you all enjoyed. But yeah, it's time we start making progress in this world again. Bye-bye.